you know, in some ways, this system is entrained, and there's something about the interruption or the pacing or whatever this acute effect is that is a release phenomena. I think it's, in essence, a disinhibition, that the cortex has been hijacked, and you're just allowing it to go back, to go about its business. But that it's something more than that, because it isn't just, you know, I get you back on track and go on your way. There's something about this system that has vulnerability, and it's such an important system to evaluate everything about stress and novelty in your world. Are things good for me, bad for me? You always use your emotional monitor to make decisions, that it has a tendency to get stuck. So it's using a normal process, but it doesn't re-equilibrate. And somehow we'll need to figure out what the electricity chronically is doing that allows the system to actually just go about its business. Because remarkably, we don't see side effects. There doesn't seem to be a price you pay to have this continuous stimulation going on all the time in this very vital network. It either works or it doesn't, but you don't, it doesn't require a higher dose over time, it doesn't wear out, and it doesn't give side effects. And so the question is, what can be wrong that this kind of intervention can just bring things back into normal tolerance limits? And equally remarkably, people's dynamic range emotionally is fine. And one of the most interesting things is, after you've been sick and dead such a long time, the early part of treatment is actually learning, relearning what it's like to have a bad day. You do have dynamic range. It doesn't take away your ability to have a bad day. You have to relearn what that feels like, because in fact, the normal ebbs and flows of normal daily life has emotional ups and downs. And for these patients, they're accustomed to being dead and deader with no dynamic range. Now they have to learn that having a bad day is sometimes just having a bad day and not a relapse. So the retraining process is very critical as well. But it's just as though this constant stimulation allows the brain to do its job and doesn't actually charge the person with, you know, having to learn to go around something as a price of recovery.